Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. It's Bo, and today we have the Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness Defender Strange figure. The figure is considered a deluxe release. It's a Target exclusive, available now. Retailing for about $31.99 on Target.com. On the outside of the package, you can see that we have the really pretty window box with the awesome portal effect in the background. You get the interchangeable hand, some art deco on the side, a small write-up, if anybody cares, and same deco on the other side. So taking a closer look, I want to check out this effect first, because I'm pretty sure everybody's really interested in this thing. This is one of the coolest things that I think that they have ever packaged in with a deluxe figure. I would love for Hasbro to do more effects like this, because I think that is what the line is lacking more than anything. They give us plenty of weapon accessories, you know, now, and they're getting a little bit better. Putting more items in, you know, what we're paying for. But like, this is what we're missing. Like, I could see this causing a lot of sellouts, and unfortunately a lot of repackaging of this figure, because people are going to want to buy these for display, you know, with Endgame displays or even just Doctor Strange sorcerer displays. I could see this going off the shelf. So it's a translucent plastic. Very, very good paint apps on here. This reminds me of the old school Toy Biz Human Torch paint scheme. Being it's translucent, I could definitely see some modders and some customizers using this and making it light up, especially like with little indentions here. You could definitely maybe hide a battery pack of some sort. The figure comes with the two hands, interchangeable here, and we've seen these before. I don't really understand why they do this all the time. They give us like a grasping hand, but there's no item for him to even hold. For those who have the old school effect with the handle, you could use this, and you know, so he can hold that. The figure itself is pretty sweet. I really, really like the paint scheme that they chose for the Defender Strange. They utilize the Pinless Tech, which is awesome. Every figure we get now should have that, in my own opinion. I mean, that is a new tech that they came out with for assembling these figures. And while we're still getting figures that have the old ones, I mean, that is such a cop-out, man. Hasbro's cheapening out, and we deserve better figures for what we're paying. Like, here is him with an effect that we don't get. So the good thing is there's plenty of these going around if you collect the other line, and you can just swap them out. Articulation, pretty good. We got good range of motion on him. We get that chest swivel there. We also get the waist articulation, which I like. Again, pinless double joints, which is awesome. We get that ball joint neck. Seems to be the new way that they're doing things, which I'm okay with. Bottom part of the figure is kind of hindered with this, I don't know what this is, like a tunic or something. But that's all you got for your leg articulation. You can't go past that, or you're going to split it right in here. You get the thigh cut, you get a little bit of a boot swivel there, and you get some rocker and some ankle. These actually look like Reeves boots. I think I've seen these. These maybe look like they came off of, the Winter Soldier Bucky, from Falcon Winter Soldier. They look very familiar. Here is the Defender Strange against the Multiverse of Madness Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness Wong figure. Defender Strange is measuring in right at 6.5 inches. Okay, so let's go over to the pros and cons. I love the figure. I think that it's a great Doctor Strange figure. I love the pinless tech that they utilized. The likeness is spot on. The photoreal tech hit it out the park. I even dig the ponytail. He's got like a Steven Seagal thing going on there. The effect is by far what puts this over for me. I think that the portal effect is awesome. The scale is right. And I could see, again, like I said, I could see this being a very hot item. And unfortunately, the cause for a lot of repacks when people are buying this and swapping the figure out, or just stealing this out. I'm going to go ahead and call that now, that's probably going to happen. Some cons, again, I just don't understand why they would package us with hands, but then we don't get any effects. Like, we could at least got one effect, or make it a different color or something, you know, do something. Even if they wanted to reuse this garbage, they could have done that, because they gave us a gripping hand, but they didn't give us anything for him to hold. So I don't like that. And then again, I'm pretty picky when it comes to the paint apps, but like, when the promo package shows something that's clearly not on the figure, I just don't understand why they don't do that. We're missing painted sling ring and buckle. The stitching and the gold outline is just not there. So that is the only cons. But again, that's not enough to make me hate this figure. I love this figure. I really can't recommend it enough. All right, guys, that's the review. I hope you enjoyed it and found it informative. I took a little bit of time to put some pictures back behind the portal effect, just to give some people ideas on maybe how you could display it. I think it's a really neat effect, and it's by far my favorite feature of this figure. If you enjoyed what you saw, give me a like, give me a subscribe and comment, and stay tuned for more content. I got more reviews on the way, and as always, keep collecting.